सर, इस बीच कुछ और जानकार भी हमारे साथ जुड़े हैं, उनसे बात करते हैं। हमारे साथ ईडी वाइस के चेयरमैन रसेश शाह इस समय जुड़े हैं, उनसे बात करते हैं। सर, शुक्रिया इस बातचीत में शामिल होने के लिए। फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल, ओवरऑल इस समय मार्केट पर आपका आउटलुक क्या है, कंसिडरिंग कि अब थोड़ा सीसो हमने बनते हुए देखा है मार्केट में, सडनली नर्वसनेस आ जाती है, लेकिन इस बार ऐसा लग रहा है कि मार्केट एक जेन्युइन रिकंस्ट्रक्शन की कोशिश कर रहा है, आपका व्यू क्या है?
We think FII inflows for the next 5 to 6 months will be fairly muted in that sense. The good news, the countervailing force on this is the flows into Indian mutual funds and the flows for Indian insurance companies are very strong. The last year we saw more than 70,000 crores of fresh inflows into equity mutual funds in India. So we think what was the FII led market investment for this year is going to be the Indian institution led market investment. So, and that will act as a floor. So the Indian institutions inflows will ensure that the market doesn't go down significantly, and the FIIs will ensure that the market does not go up significantly.
मिस्टर शाह, एक चीज और पूछना चाहूंगा आपसे, जैसे कि आपने कहा कि यहाँ पे एक बेस है, इंडियन इंस्टीट्यूशनल इन्वेस्टर्स का काफी पैसा यहाँ पर भी आया, लेकिन जो रिटेल है वो क्या करे इस वक्त, किस सेक्टर में खरीदारी करनी चाहिए?
आई थिंक वी आर इट्स अगेन कंपनी टू कंपनी, स्टॉक टू स्टॉक एंड प्राइस टू प्राइस इज व्हाट वी एडवाइज आवर इन्वेस्टर्स। वी डू थिंक दैट FY16 विल बी अ गुड ईयर फॉर अ लॉट ऑफ स्टॉक पिकिंग अपॉर्चुनिटीज फॉर इन्वेस्टर्स, डिपेंडिंग ऑन व्हाट दे आर, एंड देयर गोइंग टू बी ऑल काइंड्स ऑफ अपॉर्चुनिटीज। There are going to be growth industries which still remain IT and pharma and the Indian private sector banks and all of that. We're seeing reasonable amount of traction in four-wheeler auto. We also think there is a good contrarian bets in some of the PSUs that are available, because a lot of PSUs have factored in the worst. It is in the price, and we are seeing some amount of improvement in some PSU banks as we go forward. So it's going to be a stock picker's year as we go along, and I think that there is no industry or a sector approach that investors should take. We think investors should largely take company by company, stock by stock at a reasonable price.
जी, गोइंग फॉरवर्ड रसेश, आपको लग रहा है कि आरबीआई रेट कट करेगा अगली पॉलिसी में या फिर आने वाले एक आध क्वार्टर में, और अगर हाँ तो वो कितना कर सकते हैं?
We sincerely hope that. I think we have seen inflation has fallen significantly. We are also seeing that there is a significant growth slowdown that is happening in consumption, manufacturing, investment growth is also slowed down. We think now is a time to actually some kind of a positive shock that needs to be administered, and maybe I think it might not be bad to have at least a 50 basis point cut in the coming RBI policy. Because we need now currently both a monetary policy stimulus and a fiscal policy stimulus, and we hope that the government also starts spending now that the finance bill has been passed.
मिस्टर शाह, एक चीज और भी है, ये जो इंस्टीट्यूशनल इन्वेस्टर्स होते हैं, ये सरकार के कामकाज का अगर आप देखें कहीं ना कहीं ब्यौरा रखते भी हैं, उनका अगर आप देखें इस बात को लेकर आश्वस्त होना बहुत जरूरी है कि एक साल में कामकाज कैसा हुआ, अच्छा हुआ, बुरा हुआ, एवरेज हुआ, और एक साल में क्या एक्सपेक्टेशन है। वित्त मंत्री अरुण जेटली ने यह भी कहा है कि हमारा सेकेंड ईयर का टारगेट रहेगा ईज ऑफ डूइंग बिजनेस। खैर, वो वक्त बताएगा, लेकिन एक साल के कामकाज पर आपकी राय क्या है?
I think on the policy basis, on the reform basis, I think the government has said done enough. They've done quite a bit if you go, you know, item by item. So I would say I am fairly satisfied with the government's performance on the policy and the reform front. They've done quite a bit. I think I wish they start spending fairly quickly, because government has been fairly conservative on the fiscal side, which is a good thing when inflation was high. But now that the inflation has come off, a government can take some risk and start spending. So I'm hoping that in the next 3 to 6 months, we see significant government expenditure in areas like, you know, railways and the manufacturing for the defense industry, because I think government will have to kickstart the economy in some form or the other. So overall, I think happy with the first year. They were conservative on the fiscal side, but now I do hope that they are more expansionary on the fiscal side, and if the government starts spending, and as I said earlier, RBI also cuts rates aggressively, we might see a fairly quick revival of the economy.
बिल्कुल. नाउ कमिंग बैक टू योर बिजनेस रसेश, आपने हाल ही में अहमदाबाद में भी एक रिफाइनरी जो है उसकी कैपेसिटी बढ़ाने की बात कही है, और साथ ही इसके साथ साथ ओवरऑल आपके जो फ्यूचर प्लान्स हैं उसके बारे में अगर हम बात करें तो वो क्या है इस समय?
Yes, we do expect that basically refinery is a processing business and India has been over the years importing finished bullion. But for the last 3-4 years with MMPC having set up a refinery, our expectation is that increasingly all imports of gold in India will happen via the ore and the refining will happen in India, which is a good thing because given the government's focus on make in India, we need to at least do this, you know, simple refining processes of things that are anyway imported in India. In India, also a lot of the refining capacity in the world is in Switzerland. I think India has a lot of competitive advantages, and we do expect that India over the next 8-10 years should become a refining hub, because given our stocks of bullion, given the amount of scrap we have, given the amount of gold consumption we have, India should become one of the leading processing hubs for bullion also. But it's a 8-10 year business, and I think it is integrated with the gold bullion business that all the banks and everybody else is undertaking. We do believe that the refining will become an extension of the gold bullion import business.
चलिए मिस्टर शाह, बहुत बहुत शुक्रिया, आप इस कार्यक्रम में शामिल हुए, सभी सेक्टर्स पर बाजार पर अपनी राय रखी आपने, बहुत बहुत शुक्रिया. इस बीच निफ्टी डे हाई पर